everyone. Hello, I'm Cindy and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, then hi, welcome. So if you are my returning subscribers, oh my gosh, I'm so sorry that I have been away for some time because back then in the month of September, I was really, really sick. My physical health was super shitty. So I just needed a lot of time to recover, even all the way until October, because after my physical health issue, I also had some issues with my mental state. So yeah, it kind of just sucked that I have a lot of things to do and I want to do a lot of things, but you know, being an artist and all of that jazz and me having mental illness, it's really tough sometimes. But I'm doing so much better right now. I can say that I would say that I'm completely recovered. So talking about mental illness, this is what I really want to cover in today's topic. So now I am back with another digital art painting process, and this is a fan art inspired by the movie Midsommar. I think that's how you pronounce it, right? So if you don't know what that is, it's basically like a horror thriller movie, a Midsommar, by the director Ari Aster. I hope I pronounced his name correctly. And he was also the director of the super famous and successful horror movie called Hereditary. And I highly recommend you to watch it, especially Midsommar, which is his second movie. It just came out not that too long ago, actually. And a lot of people said that, oh, it's really gory and a lot of violence and it's just like fucking weird and creepy. But when I watch it, it's not gory. I at least for me personally, I don't find it gory. I don't find it violent. There's not even a jump scare. But what really, really triggered me is how well the characters play their parts, their acting. Because Ari Aster is a true master of creating a psychological, metaphorical type of horror film. So he actually take the concept of a relationship breakup, you know, love, heartbreaks, into his horror movie. So just go ahead and watch it, but just know that if you do get quite easily triggered by some, I would say, some mental issues, then just be cautious on watching that, because I have mental illness. And the main character, the main actress that plays Dani, she is super amazing. The way that she cry and the way that she, you know, play this character that has mental illness, depression. And I think the character Dani also has bipolar. It's so freaking realistic to the point that it scared a lot of people because how realistic it is. And all of the soundtracks, the movie effects and everything, it just make it feel so dreamy yet realistic. So even though it's a horror film, but because it's psychological as well, a lot of people can actually relate, and that is what makes it really, really creepy. So in this video of this painting that I'm doing, this is a quote inspired fan art because, you know, I am creating my own character, but of course the mood, the theme, the atmosphere of it is highly inspired by Midsommar, especially the scene at the very end of that movie. So I'm not gonna spoiler it because probably some of you haven't watched it yet, but then again, I highly recommend you to watch it. And this talks a lot about letting go of a toxic relationship. I personally relate to this a lot. And oh, and if you're new here to my channel, then you may expect that my channel is a lot about art, but also personal growth and spirituality as well. So you can say that my channel and my Instagram at Amorinet as well is kind of like a personal blog. You know, I used to only do art, but now I would also like to share something more personal because I do care a lot about personal growth and spirituality, as it is such a huge part of me. I cannot separate that. That is me as an artist, as a person. And I use art as a wonderful tool of therapy, of expression, in hopes that people can relate to it as well and learn lessons from my story. So now a little bit about what I personally want to share is that with this movie Midsommar, I relate a freaking lot to the character Dani, which is the main actress here, the main character. And at the end of this movie, it really is about letting everything burn away, like burning the bridges to start something new, to feel accepted and be in the environment where you actually feel that you can fit in. But you know, this movie, it shows a lot of craziness, toxic relationship and friendship as well. So I'm not taking it as literal, you know, I just relate to some of the things that the character Dani experienced, especially about a toxic, manipulative and gaslighting relationship, because in the past I experienced a relationship like that. It's very personal, but from now on I would like to share more of my own experiences so that I can, you know, inspire other people, or that you can take it as a grain of salt, or maybe you can take it as a lesson, anything at all. Maybe you find it helpful as well, or even healing. But you really have to be careful when it comes to red flags, especially. This is what it really hit me in this movie, is that when you clearly know that there is such a huge red flag, you really have to communicate clearly with your partner. And if they don't want to communicate that with you, if they dismiss that, and even worse, if they backfire it to you, they backfire it to your fucking face and act like they're the victim. If they try to guilt trip you and gaslight you, oh my gosh, that is a major, major red flag. And the really shitty part about being in a really toxic and manipulative relationship as well is that it's going to take a long ass time for you to realize that you're in a manipulative relationship and for you to get out of it and heal, because you are so fucked, you are so manipulated to the point that it's really hard for someone to realize that they are being manipulated. But at that time when I was experiencing that relationship, I was really, really young. You know, I was still back at school, at high school, and I didn't know any better. But that was such a hard lesson, you know, a hard swallow pill. That I think that's what they call it, right? That I really need to learn, and it was such a valuable, precious, precious lesson that I will hold dear until this very point of my life, because it taught me a lot about manipulations and lies and toxicity and what I need to do to become more aware of it. So that is why, if you are a returning subscriber and you've been following me, especially my recent videos, I began to share a lot more about personal growth and spirituality. You may notice that I often use my art as a way to express self-love and also self-respect as well. And actually some months ago, I think, or just like a few months ago, I created a video about self-love, self-love therapy, using art as a tool of therapy, as art as a tool to attract what you really want in your life, to manifest that dream life, that love, that abundance, whatever it is that you really want in your life. And I use art as a way to express that, and as a tool, as like a magnet as well, to attract those things that I want in my life. So if you're interested in that, if you feel called to, you can go ahead, check it out. I can just leave the link down below in the description. And I feel that, you know, self-love is really, really important, because you just have to keep pushing through to heal and learn how to respect yourself, to know your own boundaries. Because a lot of times I notice that when people experience issues in their relationship, it's because they're not communicating clearly. And one of the top reasons because of that, it's because of you don't even know your own boundaries. You don't even know your own limit. So you have to first love yourself, respect yourself, and be highly aware what you want, what you need, what you can compromise, and what you cannot compromise, so that you can communicate very clearly, respectfully, and full of compassion together with your partner. You know, like a heart-to-heart conversation. Because Nowadays, sadly, we live in a generation where people are so used to getting ghosted or ghosting other people instead of actually communicating. A lot of people find communication as something aggressive because they're not used to talk and express about their feelings. So instead of just talking calmly, they view it as, oh, are you trying to argue with me or are you trying to fight with me? Because, you know, at the end of the day, couples do fight, couples do debate or argue. You know, as long as its balance is actually healthy, what's really important is that people just really need to communicate in a respectful and compassionate manner where you can trust each other and at least on the same page. Different opinions, different thoughts, different perspective, that's normal. But what's really not normal and so not healthy is when you repress things and decide to dismiss that. Again, remember, dismissing anything that is actually important to be talked about is really unhealthy and it's just going to ruin you. It's going to ruin everyone involved. And again, here we're talking about a relationship that is just going to be toxic and unhealthy. It's not going to grow, it's not going to improve, because if you let it repressed all the way 6 feet under the ground, then you can literally expect for that relationship to go downhill or even go all the way dead. It's not like always that dramatic, but that's what often happens. So then again, it's always about awareness. So that is what I really want to share with you today. I hope you enjoy this video and enjoy this topic. Let me know down in the comments what you feel and what you think about this topic, and if there's anything else that you would like for me to talk about or to share, go ahead and check out my Instagram as well at Amorinette. If you would like to connect with me more personally, I share you know, my IG story almost every day and I update things. So yeah, I will see you there on my Instagram as well. And yeah, I will definitely be back with more videos, but please do be patient with me. I am still recovering. I'm gonna go back again, but I'm still in the process of making more content so I can be more consistent in this. But then again, my mental health and my physical health still comes first, and I'm still improving myself as well. So I send you so much love and light. Take care. And yeah, I'm going to, you know, end this video and be back. Oh, and don't forget to like and subscribe and click the bell ring as well. And I will see you soon.